Reports on a woman who slipped through the cracks of a corporate collapse and has been paying the price every day for more than a decade.
I've been living in my garage for 14 years.
Got me beat how people can live that way.
I've got no electricity, I've got no running water.
It's getting to a stage where it's quite dangerous.
The rats and the mice and the snakes.
A tragic house fire and an insurer that wouldn't pay up has left Christine Dooling living in her shed for 14 painful years. No power, no water, no company.
No, most people wouldn't be able to cope. It is lonely.
The 62-year-old invalid pensioner was lucky to escape with her life after her house went up in flames.
I tripped over my bedding with a Kero lamp and the Kero lamp shattered and burnt the house down.
To Christine's shock, insurer HIH denied her claim.
They said because I was behind my mortgage, I deliberately burnt it down.
She sought legal advice, but it was too late. HIH went into liquidation. So she made do with this shed. She's been making do ever since.
There's my light, the candle. There's my cooking, heating and hot water. This is my bed.
Yep.
It's a kitchen.
Is that a kitchen table?
It's a Lamex kitchen table, yeah.
Around 4 o'clock every day, while most of us are finishing up at work, Christine goes to bed, reading by candlelight, her only source of entertainment.
This is a modern age. It shouldn't be. People shouldn't live that way.
Neighbour Neville Dutton says her situation's more than sad, it's life-threatening.
The snakes net around. You got dirty, great big black spiders, redbacks, some of the deadliest reptiles in the world. Eh?
And there's no shortage of thieves either.
Opening the panels out of the garage wall and climbing in, getting in and just carting away my stuff.
She's got really no security. Like the shed's sitting out in the middle of a paddock.
They took items precious to Christine but of no great cash value, so the police showed little interest.
It is tough and we know that people are doing it hard at the moment.
Council of the Ageing CEO Sue Hendy says it's an all too common situation for older Australians.
Older people and older women particularly have been moving into their cars and living on the street, and there are more older people at risk of homelessness now.
Christine gets $345 a week from the government. The cheapest private rental near Clunes in regional Victoria is around $130 a week. Then there's all the weekly costs that come with it, which could leave Christine in the red.
She grins and bears it.
I've got no choice.
People are on a pension, need a fair go. The costs upon them are increasing, the income isn't.
Stuck in a shed smaller than most lounge rooms, Christine is clinging to the life she had before.
Your possessions are so important to you. Everything's got a memory. And if you're throwing that out, you're throwing away memory.
Psychologist Simon Kinsella.
She's showing all the classic signs of hoarding.
So how is this hoarding behaviour?
It's very disorganised. There's no clear structure to what she's doing. And as you can see, there are knickknacks around there that really aren't of much material value.
But when you're by yourself and you've got no social life, you know, you've got your memories and you just don't want to throw them away.
Christine's not alone. Psychologists say 5% of the population are hoarders.
Hoarding is a lot more common than first thought.
Over the years, we've seen all kinds of people collect everything from cars to musical instruments, even junk from the tip. In some cases, it's gone horribly wrong. The clutter and combustibles catching on fire. As for Christine...
I've been living here for 14 years. I'll be here for the rest of my life.
Making the best of what she's got, which ain't much.